Looking at a piston pump made by the Ahrens Fox Fire Engine Company of Cincinnati. It was made in 1922, but they were making pumps like this from 1915 until 1952. And basically, we have the pressure dome that we had with the horse-drawn and the hand-drawn piston pumps and sometimes rotary pumps. And we've got pistons down here from the piston systems that we had talked about earlier. I have a diagram that I'd like to share with you. And hopefully this will help a tiny bit. So if you think of the red areas as being the water coming into the middle, that's the suction side. So this red square at the middle is going to be right here. This is going into the red square of the pump, is right here. And then above it is a set of valves. There are many more valves here and many more valves here. So there's a set here and a set here, and then a duplicate set here and here. So this is a double acting system, so that when this piston is going up, it is drawing water from the red section through these valves into the bottom of that side. At the same time that this is going up and drawing the water in, it's pushing the water that was above it into this area and pushing those valves open or up. So this water under pressure is now going into the upper and or the area that surrounds. So we've got 40 rubber valves in this pump that are 2 7/8 inches in diameter, and they're all on spiral springs, and they're going up and down depending on which direction the piston's going in. We have 4 pistons, whereas on the steam engine, we saw 2 at the most, sometimes 1. This has 4. Ahrens Fox also built a model that had 6 pistons. And so we have what is called a positive displacement pump, like the rotary pump, like the hand engines of yore. This is a positive displacement pump. So the water is coming in, and then it's from into the middle section, it's being pushed from the middle section into the outer section. So then this outer jacket is the pressure side, and the pressure is, and the outgoing water is now coming out to the hoses from this outer layer. And the pump is capable of generating up to 300 PSI. We will run this at 250 pounds to raise our Baltimore water tower. They had pumps that could do up to 500. They were specially built by Ahrens Fox. The engine itself, or the pump itself, is like any other positive displacement pump that we've talked about. It has controls for letting the water circulate. It has relief valves. It has safety controls. And it was the most sophisticated pump that was built in the United States. It also had the most parts. It had the most expensive parts. And so when the centrifugal, series parallel centrifugal pump became common after 1927, then this pump became more and more, I'll say, deluxe. I don't want to say obsolete, but it was less easy for a fire chief to justify the cost of this machine when he could get a centrifugal pump that would be infinitely cheaper and be a lot less trouble to maintain. The other thing that's important about comparing centrifugals to piston pumps in the modern era, let's say after 1930, is that cities had substantial hydrant systems by that time. And so a centrifugal pump, particularly, and I'm thinking of the series parallel centrifugal pump, could take the water from a hydrant system and just build onto it and add the energy necessary to get the water to the final pressure. Whereas this engine had to basically start from zero, and it did its entire work with the gasoline engine pushing the water ahead. So there are many advantages to the centrifugal pump if you've got a good water system underneath of it.
Well, thank you, Steve.
You're welcome.
Again, where are we at today?
We're at the Fire Museum of Maryland.
Where was this located?
Located in Lutherville, which is just due north of Baltimore City. We're right on the Baltimore Beltway, and we invite you to come see us. We are open on Saturdays, but in the summer, we're open more days, 4 days a week. We also do tours by appointment, so please give us a call. Check our website, firemuseummd.org.
Thanks, Steve.
You're welcome.